Well, tonight here in Landover, Maryland, a long way from Quito, Ecuador, they'll do it again as number one Bernard Hopkins and number two Segundo Mercado vie for the vacant IBF middleweight championship. And a man who knows a thing or two about championship fights joins us right now as we welcome undisputed world heavyweight champion Mike Tyson to tonight's broadcast. And first of all, Mike, good to have you with us. Welcome.
Nice seeing you again, Steve.
All right, Mike, we look forward to your comments throughout the night. And, of course, the fans, the media, and the curious have all been anticipating this moment. Mike, is there anything that you'd like to say to start things off?
Well, I'm happy to be back. Not only is Vince coming back and fighting and gaining my title, but working with commentary with you and now.
All right, your thoughts on the strategy in a rematch after a draw, which we have here coming up in our co-feature.
This should be an interesting fight. Last fight, as you know, I wasn't here to view the fight, but I listened to the fight over the phone.
Well,
and it was dynamite then, and I'm expecting a dynamite fight now, but I'm going towards Hopkins.
All right. Well, as we said, we look forward to Mike's commentary throughout the evening. And as mentioned, we also eagerly await word on Mike's plans for the immediate future later in this telecast. Well, right now, we're going to get a look at number two-rated Segundo Mercado as he gets ready to make his way to the ring. The 28-year-old Mercado, 18-2-1 with 11 knockouts, having won six in a row prior to his draw with Hopkins. The success of Segundo Mercado has not come without a price. 1 week before his first fight with Bernard Hopkins, his 29-year-old sister Marta committed suicide. A few weeks before that, his longtime friend and mentor, General Miguel Iturralde of Quito's Elite Military Academy, died tragically in a helicopter crash. Two shattering blows to this man. Yet he moved on and dedicated his last fight to their memories. And Fernie, how will Mercado be affected tonight, fighting outside of his country for the first time since 1991 and not having the massive support of the 16,000 fans he had in Ecuador?
Well, in a curious way, he said, it's a relief. I mean, all these guys behind me in my country put on such pressure that I can't fight my normal, easy-flowing fight. I'm under such pressure to do well. I feel like I'm released from all that, and I can flow like I usually do, and I can have my kind of fight. I know I got to knock this guy out to win here. I've got to knock Hopkins out, and I can only do it if I'm loose and flowing and so forth. So as far as he's concerned, he's taking a very healthy attitude. He's glad he's in here without 16,000 people on his back.
Even his trainer, Tommy Gallagher, admitted they will need a knockout. And now, the number one rated contender, Bernard the Executioner Hopkins, wearing the trademark mask, looking to become the first middleweight champ from his hometown of Philadelphia. The 30-year-old Hopkins comes in 26-2-1, 19 KOs. Of his 19 knockouts, 12 have come in the first round and four others inside the third.
your house, so you're living in parking lot. Now I really care, and my mom, she can't figure. You never see my baby, cause it's stuck to my trigger. Growing up in the hood, too bad it was a rough child. I never gave his back, and had to go and sing it. Ooh, child, it's gonna get easier. But I'm bringing ladies, stepping back and squeezing ya. Like a Charmin, straight for your family, you're the army. I'm doing your boy, you're so now I'm living on the farm. I'm throwing up some wonder, so I'm always storming. I get so blood, baby, that my body was the former.
Being accompanied by some great ex-fighters, Michael Spinks and Joe Frazier. Bernard, who put his name on the map in May of 93 when he went 12 hard rounds with Roy Jones Jr. for the vacant IBF middleweight title. Hopkins, virtually unknown at the time, lost by decision, but put on a gutsy performance. When Jones vacated the title to step up in white, Hopkins had another opportunity for the title, but fought the draw with Mercado. Tonight, once again, his dream of winning a world championship can come true. And Bobby, this time against Mercado, Hopkins doesn't have the altitude problems or the strain or the distractions he told us he had in Ecuador. He can concentrate strictly on fighting, so he feels he has the distinct advantage tonight.
Well, you know, he didn't feel that the altitude affected him as it might have, but he did box differently because of it, so it was a consideration. Also, he thought the judges were influenced by the hostile crowd, but now here, he's got a very Hopkins-friendly audience. He's in single, the altitude is sea level. He should have no problems. I thought he won the first fight, Steve. He thought he won the first fight. He thinks he has the better skills. That's all the confidence he's going to need.
All right, Bobby, let's see how they stack up on paper now as we go to the tail of the tape. Hopkins at age 32 years older than Mercado. Mercado at 6'2", the 2-inch height advantage. Mercado right on the weight limit at 160. Hopkins 158 and a 3-inch reach advantage for Mercado. And the rules for this championship fight being governed by the state of Maryland, which overruled the IBF. 10-point mush system, 3 scoring judges. No standing 8 count, no 3 knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. And a fighter cannot be saved by the bell except in the last round. So here at the U.S. Air Arena in Landover, Maryland, we're closing in on our co-feature, the battle for the vacant IBF middleweight championship, Bernard Hopkins versus Segundo Mercado. Let's get the official introductions from our ring announcer, the classy Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you, and we welcome you to the U.S. Air Arena in Landover, Maryland, as we have a big night of action coming your way, the Beltway Brawl, brought to you by Don King Productions in association with La Cerveza Más Fina Corona Beer. At this time, we present the first of our World Championship featured bouts of the evening, and it is sanctioned by the International Boxing Federation, the President Robert Lee Sr., Supervisor at ringside Marion Muhammad, along with the Maryland State Athletic Commission, the Chairman D. Chester O'Sullivan. At this time, I present the officials, the judges scoring this bout from ringside, Robert Exton, Sheila Harmon Martin, and John Stewart. Presenting to you the referee in charge of this bout, working in this, his 64th world title bout, Rudy Battle. All right, fans, here we go with a rematch for the vacant IBF middleweight championship of the world. It is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Presenting to you first on my left, fighting out of the blue corner. He enters the ring wearing blue and white trunks and joining us all the way from Quito, Ecuador. He weighed in at the middleweight limit of 160 pounds, and he brings a professional record into the ring of 18 wins, 2 losses, 1 draw, with 11 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight he is attempting to be the first Ecuadorian to win a world title. Please welcome the number 2 ranked IBF middleweight contender, introducing Segundo. And his opponent across the ring on my right, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks and hailing from the big fight town of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He weighed in at a ready 158 pounds, and his record includes 26 wins, 2 losses, 1 draw, with 19 wins coming by way of knockout. And tonight, he is making his third attempt at a world crown. He is ranked the number 1 middleweight contender by the IBF. Please welcome the fighter known as the Executioner, introducing Bernard Hopkins. Hawkins. Once again, here's the referee in charge now to give instructions, Rudy Battle.
Okay, gentlemen, I've given you both your pre-fight instructions. I expect a clean break at all times. And when I tell you to break, I want you both to stop punching, step back, protect yourselves at all times. I don't want any hitting on the break, no punching after the bell. All right, let's have a nice, clean fight. Good luck to both of you. All right, let's touch gloves. Touch them up. All right.
Well, that was a major league stare down. The third man of the ring, Rudy Battle, almost took an uppercut from both. Bernard Hopkins, very trim and fit, well-defined body, solid skilled fighter, has speed and power. Segundo Mercado, one of 12 children, originally from the tropical beach area of Esmeraldas, Ecuador, home to the descendants of African slaves. He's a hard hitter, an excellent puncher, and a very good buster. And here we go, round one, scheduled for 12 for the IBF middleweight championship that is currently vacant. This is the rematch from a very good fight that had so much ebb and flow back in Ecuador.
I'll tell you, Steve, the way they touch gloves, you'd think they don't like each other.
You get that feeling.
Well, the last time, you remember, Hopkins came out just blazing and took that first round so clearly that Mercado said, if you'd have kept that up, you'd have knocked me out. And he didn't in the second round, of course. That was a wonderful fight. All the makings of a great fight also.
I've never heard a fighter admit that, Ferdy.
Neither have I, Bobby. I think I'd faint if I heard you say, well, he could have knocked me out if he kept going for the next two rounds. I don't remember a fighter ever saying that.
Very candid comments from Mercado. Interestingly, in the end, it seemed like Hopkins, who was knocked down twice in the fight, seemed in better shape than Mercado, despite the altitude problem with thin air. In fact, Hopkins arrived in Ecuador just 2 days before the fight, allowing him almost no time to acclimate.
You know, he made mention of the fact that in the second round he came out boxing a little more because he was worried about that altitude, but there were no effects in the 10th, 11th, and 12th round.
Well, Mercado's not holding back in this first round. He's going right at it. Little instruction from Rudy Battle. Got a little mad. Said, you guys are starting to fight dirty now. Let's keep it clean. Let's not have a dirty fight tonight.
Hopkins in the black trunks. Landing a left hook there to the side of Mercado. From the tough streets of Philadelphia is Bernard Hopkins. Had an adolescence marred by a series of wrongdoings. He has turned his life around, now living a clean and honest life. Mike devotes much time working with kids in juvenile detention centers, so it's nice to see a guy like Hopkins turn things around through boxing.
Oh, well, yes, I've been very familiar with Mr. Hopkins for a few years, and he's always been a stand-up gentleman, and I commend him on all of his accomplishments. Besides being a great fighter, he's also a great individual.
Talking about Bernard Hopkins, who, it's hard to believe, looking to become the first middleweight champion from the boxing-rich city of Philadelphia.
He's certainly not having his way like he did in Quito. He's met a completely different Segundo here. Segundo is fighting back and taking some of this round with his sharp counter punches.
Segundo's fighting a better defensive fight. He's covering himself up. He's watching the blocking punches much better. He's effectively countering Hopkins right now.
Hopkins said by not winning in Ecuador, it may have saved his life. The pressure on Mercado was just enormous. The whole country depending on him. And here, as he put it, nobody really knows him, so he's a lot looser.
Well, hit on the back of the head just then, and that's the kind of thing we've been trying to stop. We've seen so much of it in the last three or four fights we've had, and the referee popped right in there and said, that's on the back of the head. Don't do that again. Got to stay on top of that.
Final seconds of round one for the vacant IBF middleweight championship.
Double shot.
Take it by the feet. Take it by the other.
His trainer speaks English. I don't know how they're getting that through to Mercado because no one translated. He just said, both corners said, you're doing good, just like you're doing, keep that up. So both apparently satisfied with the performance, both apparently thinking that their fighter won the first round.
Well, Mercado's trainer is Tommy Gallagher of New York. Mercado speaks a little English. Right hand there by Hopkins that missed. Hopkins said he felt he had the better skills in Ecuador, but he was psyched out, overwhelmed by things like armed soldiers in his dressing room, kicking doors in the bathroom for security purposes. Unbelievable. Mike, anything like that ever happened to you?
No, not at all.
That is incredible.
And if it was, I would never allow it to affect me.
Well, he certainly felt that it affected him, although he did fight to the draw and did not lose.
Let him go.
I'll tell you what, Steve, that type of thing, I guess, could affect you when you see it. The fighters, that Mike knows this too, they have a mind frame. When they get in the ring, they can't see anything else, hear anything else, or let anything else in, or it's going to affect them, and it's just part of the game.
Hopkins got to do a little bit better than he did in that first round. He's got to take command here, and he just can't. This guy keeps battling back. Low punches, marginal low punches by Segundo Mercado.
Segundo's moving more, too. Using a little more foot movement, trying to box a little bit. But this fight is nothing like the first one so far.
So far, not at all.
In the first fight, Hopkins came out very aggressively in the first round, and to the surprise of Mercado, he boxed in the second round. But a good pace to the first few rounds in this fight so far. Both just pouring it on.
And as you noted, Mercado is a very elusive fighter. Very difficult to connect with a solid punch. And he makes the fight so exciting because he's so close and he's moving, and it makes it as if the other guy is trying, but it's almost effortless because he's not landing solidly.
Mercado 18-2-1 with 11 knockouts, rated number 2, his second world title.
Oh, was that low?
That looked like a blatant low blow, and
yeah,
Rudy and Battle didn't even see it.
He didn't see it because he was between the two fighters. But wow, was that low.
Wild miss there by Hopkins.
I think in the first fight, these guys may have gotten a little too much respect for one another.
Yeah, 30 seconds left. These guys, I believe, are too familiar with one another. It's as if they're not as putting out as much effort as in the first fight.
It's almost as if they hurt each other enough in the first fight. They got too much respect for each other, Mike, and they're not brawling like they did in that first fight.
But then again, the fight is early.
Yeah, it just started.
The last fight back December the 17th at Ecuador. A majority draw.
An exchange of punches here in the last. All right, it's over.
Here's what a picture-perfect low blow looks like when the referee's not watching. Now watch, the referee gets between them, whoom, right there. Can't possibly be any harder and any better. The referee didn't see it, and it apparently didn't affect the fighter, Bernard Hopkins.
All right, this is round number 3. You know, Mike, I think I inadvertently called you the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. Of course, the world knows you're the former. But perhaps I was just a little premature.
No, I feel that way.
Once a champion, always a champion, right?
Oh, look out. Big left hook by Hopkins.
Legs.
And he's got Mercado holding on. Look at how he's holding, Mike. Looks like he's got him in a death grip there.
Yeah, this is amazing. It came out of nowhere.
Oh,
Home blown there by Mercado.
But a good hammering shot by Hopkins right back.
Hopkins is stepping in with his punches and timing Mercado now. He's a little not used to that movement that Mercado's given, which he didn't give in the first fight. He's starting to get the timing and the rhythm of it down.
So big left hand wobbling Mercado, 17 seconds into round three.
I believe Hopkins should throw more punches to the body. He's throwing punches to this guy's head, and Mercado's extremely elusive.
Mercado getting in some digging shots now to the midsection of Hopkins.
You see Hopkins turning that right hand in. He's got bad intentions on this punch. The hook, too. He's turning his punches over big.
Warm-up.
All right, great, great, great.
Action's starting to warm up here, Bobby.
Uh-oh, he went down from a...
Take your time!
He just kneeled out. He'd been hit twice and low. But I guess it's nothing. Nothing.
That was interesting. Hopkins went down to 1-8. Now he bores in again. Left hook to the head of Mercado.
And another bad left low blow by Mercado. But Mercado looks like he's hurt.
Mercado's legs are not under, Mike. He's in trouble.
Not at all. He stepped right in with the right hand.
Mercado is dazed as Hopkins continues to pour it on. Bearing in with shots to the midsection. Mercado comes back with a left hook to the midsection of Hopkins.
Great elusive skills from Mercado.
A very game. Segundo Mercado hanging in there despite that assault by Hopkins.
Another very low blow by Mercado. If he wasn't that elusive, he'd have gotten knocked out then, Mike, because he was in all kind of trouble.
Well, as you know, most of these Latin American fighters are extremely elusive fighters, and the majority of them work on the defense.
Well, he certainly has got A-plus on that because he knows how to slip and slide.
His legs just don't look like they're under him, Steve. He's getting hit too clean, and he's taking something out of him.
Mercado earlier surviving quite a barrage from Bernard Hopkins here with 10 seconds to go in the third round.
And the battle starting to surge toward Hopkins.
Hopkins throwing with extremely hard body punches.
Take that big right hand early that shook Mercado completely.
You see he gets him in the corner. He leads with that right hand. He digs the hook in, puts his head right in his chest, and rips punches around his guard. Hopkins means business. Ripping uppercuts on the inside, throwing punches from all the angles, getting the job done.
Well, he certainly shook off the cobwebs of that first round. Has come on in the second and has really dominated the third.
Round four scheduled for 12 for the IBF middleweight championship, which is vacant. We come off a very good round for Bernard Hopkins. Mercado was bouncing around on his toes earlier. Hopkins' ferocious attack might have slowed him down.
I doubt it very seriously here, Steve, because he's just timing and waiting and, I mean, being very patient. And eventually, I believe he's going to catch him again. Because as you see right now, Mercado doesn't seem very stable at this moment. And the round just begun.
Yeah, I think he took a lot of whipping there. He was shaking as he went back to the corner. I don't think he recuperated fully, and his punches aren't that brisk as he was before. But as you say, that defensiveness stays with you.
Either he still hurt Mercado or he's very leery of the punching power of Hopkins. Because as I said earlier, Hopkins throwing hydrogen bombs in, especially to the body. And that's enough to slow any man down.
If Mercado lets Hopkins keep coming forward like this, he can't win the fight. He turned the southpaw just now, very briefly. Wasn't effective and didn't really do anything. But
look,
just
at the
trying to confuse Hopkins.
Hopkins going to the body. Rudy Battle trying to get in to break him up. Get the punches up, says Battle. midway through the fourth round.
Conversation there is because the referee was trying to break him up and he got hit on the break. Mercado shot a punch on the break and hit Hopkins, and he got warned for it.
You watch Hopkins, he leaps in with some of the shots too. It also could be dangerous for him. If Mercado steps him in a shot, he could drop Hopkins.
I agree 100%, Bobby. He's off balance and there's no balance there, and the slightest push would throw him on the ground and make it look bad, even though it wouldn't be disastrous.
You know what's happening to Hopkins? He's getting so much confidence now that he's not being aware of the basics there. He's just coming right after him. He didn't care what it's like.
Bernard Hopkins in the black trunks. Segundo Mercado in the blue and white. Under 30 seconds in the fourth. Uppercuts by Mercado. Against the ropes of the body of Hopkins.
I'll tell you, that's some great infighting, Steve. A couple of them have been south of the border. That's some tremendous infighting.
By both fighters. Oh, nice right hand.
A right hook.
Right hand.
Oh, and now a left hook by Hopkins.
And he is in big trouble as Segundo.
Segundo's just holding on, nothing more.
The bell sounds.
Oh, boy. Is this turned this fight completely around? It is all in Bernard Hopkins' hands. Let's listen.
Come on. No, not on the back. Come on. The back. Let's go. Fight him. Body punch.
Fire,
baby. Go back him up with that jab. Huh?
Yeah.
Combination going. Come on. You got to be tough in there.
I'll tell our mama.
Come on, brother. Fight him. Body punch. Ready to kill.
All right. Let's take a look at that right hand. That have been a little bit lower. He goes to the canvas. As it is, you can see he's in big, big trouble. It was high on the forehead, like on the brow of the eye. Two great shots, and he's on his way, but the bell rings.
Well, I'll tell you what, if you look at it again, he gets hit off the temple, right on the side of the head, where we've seen Terry Norris and other fighters get really seriously hurt. But he comes in here with a right hand and a hook. That hook is really clean.
And out comes Hopkins with devilment in his eyes.
Round number five. Big punches at the end of round four by Bernard Hopkins.
Now just imagine if he used the jab, Bernard Hopkins, punched the body and then went to the head and did it in a rapid fashion. The fight would be totally different, even though it's very much in his favor.
Nice hook that throws Mercado back. Mercado's still not all there, shaken from that big beating he took right at the bell.
The difference in this fight, Freddie, has been Hopkins' timing and counterpunching. They've been real solid. Again, the timing is unbelievable.
Another heavy right hook by Bernard Hopkins.
Only this time with a lot of time. Can he survive this?
Mercado again hanging in there despite this barrage that he is punching back. Breathing heavily, his mouth wide open.
Bernard Hopkins has to stop landing in front of him. As he heard him, he stays in front of him, and he gives Mercado a time to come back and look good because his head is still in the center.
And then a straight left by Hopkins. Flush on the face of Mercado. Oh, and Mercado take a punch.
Mercado's getting hit with everything flush, Steve, and everything he throws back isn't landing clean.
A lot of time, a minute 35 remaining in the fifth. Can Mercado get through this round?
Well, Mercado's fighting back.
Hopkins is too impatient. He has to get around. He has to stay from in front of him.
Hopkins also has to make sure he doesn't punch himself out.
Exactly.
And let Mercado get a second win.
And oh, what a stinging straight left hand by Bernard Hopkins, who continues to dictate the pace. Oh, a heavy right.
You see how he jumps on the right hand, Steve? He's jumping and he's leaping in with it, which can be dangerous, but right now, Mercado can do nothing with it.
And still a lot of time, just under a minute remaining in the fifth.
Mike, you think you can finish him off by the end of this round?
I believe the fight won't end the round. The round will end and the fight will be over. He will not finish the round.
Rudy Battle looking on intently.
Oh, Rudy's almost in there.
Every shot, Steve, is so clean.
Hopkins continues to pour.
I don't believe if he does, it's incredible.
I don't know what Battle's waiting for. He's getting the
What is holding Mercado?
is really brave here.
25 seconds to go in the fifth round. Amazing punishment to Mercado.
And he's fighting back, Steve. He's still fighting back.
Now, what is that? How much time are they giving with that little warning?
What a gutty effort here by Mercado. He may make it through this round. Astonishing.
Is that the good news or the bad news?
Wild miss there by Hopkins.
This is amazing.
He's made it through the round.
This is amazing that he made it through that round.
Take care of that big, big punch that got him in trouble right at the beginning of the round. See that? Right on the forehead and the nose, right on the bridge of the nose there. And from there on out, it was a continuous punishment. Bobby.
Well, later in the round, you see, jumps in with the right hand. Once again, he's been jumping in. He's been timing him perfectly. He comes in with the left hand behind it. And again, he'll back him up in the corner, jump in with another right hand, right on the butt. He's just diving in with all the big shots.
And he's diving in with all the power. Looks like he's throwing that from Washington Monument back there. Up with that punch.
Well, let's see what Bernard Hopkins has left. I believe he looks to be totally spent after that last second in there.
Well, he should be, but Mike, I put a question to you. Would you rather be tired because you took a beating or rather be tired because you gave a beating?
I gave one.
Yeah, right. That's Hopkins' position.
Good answer.
A huge round for Hopkins. Mike, do you think that could have been scored, even though there was no knockdown, you think that could have been scored a 10-8 round?
No, I believe Hopkins won that round.
Oh, no question about it. But a 10-8 or 10-9? It could have been a 10-8 round.
Well, I'm good at knocking people out. I'm not good at scoring it.
Well, let me tell you, my opinion was a 10-8 because it was such an overwhelming beating. You don't have to go down to get a 10-8 round. He got a whole three-minute beating.
And I will concur. A 10-8 round on my scorecard as well. That was just a tremendous beating, pillar to post, from opening bell to the end.
So as you see right now, Bernard Hopkins is allowing Mercado to come on now.
Well, he should be tired. He should goof this round off. I mean, you know, get himself back together. His mouth is open. He should be tired. But then again, the other guy is so spent. This should be a waltz this round.
Oh, what a straight right hand. A lead right by Bernard Hopkins. Again, right on the chin. Right on the button.
Mercado just cannot seem to stop it. He doesn't see it coming here. Everyone, Steve.
Another bomb. Lead by Bernard Hopkins. Everything connecting, landing, flush. A very wobbly Segundo Mercado hanging in there. And again, a lot of time left in the round.
Isn't it ironic that as soon as Mercado gets hurt, he becomes very evasive?
Yeah.
I also agree with
him. Look at that right hand again.
He uses the jab behind that. It's got to be just that much easier.
And Mike, I remind you of the Joe Louis Schmeling fight when Schmeling knew how to hit him with a right hand, how to hit Joe Louis. He hit him all night long.
All night long.
And he's doing the same thing here. He doesn't know how to block a right hand night long.
And Bernard Hopkins is doing it without the jab.
Yeah, so right.
Imagine if he had the jab behind it.
Mercado fighting back. Throwing uppercuts.
It was a nice attempt at a counter right by Mercado, but he right now is taking such a beating that I don't know if his body has enough left to ward off Bernard Hopkins.
He certainly cannot solve the problem of the right hand.
Mercado continues to get pummeled here, but showing tremendous heart.
Well, it was every bit as good as the fight in Quito. Both of them unloading on each other as much as they can. What a fight.
I can't imagine Mercado lasting the fifth round. We're in the sixth round now, and he's getting hit again with the right hand. It's happening all night. The fight can't go the distance.
Well, coming up next, our main event as they go into the dressing room of the challenger, three-time world champion Simon Brown, getting set to take on fellow Maryland resident Vincent Petway for the IBF junior middleweight title. 2 years ago, the veteran Brown stunned the boxing world with his fourth-round knockout of Terry Norris, but after one defense against Troy Waters, Norris regained the crown in the rematch with Brown. Tonight, Simon Brown looks to get back on the championship throne with a victory over Vincent Petway. So we're here at US Air Arena in Landover, Maryland. Steve Albert along with Ferdy Pacheco, Bobby Chez, and Mike Tyson.
Let's take a look at that right hand. That seems to be the exclusive property of Bernard Hopkins. He just throws it when he wants, and it lands right where he's throwing it.
As we continue on. Bernard Hopkins picking up where he left off.
It's just unbelievable to me that this man does not even put his hand up to defend against that right hand. Lean to the right, lean to the left, put a hand up something.
And at least don't stand right in front of him to receive it. Give him some angles, move to some side. I mean, the guy is right there like a railroad track to his head.
At this point of the first fight in Ecuador back in mid-December, Mercado was ahead on two of the three scorecards.
Oh,
that was a heavy right hand. That right hand was better than the other because he caught Mercado coming in and walked right into it.
There's a lot of time left.
And that is a big factor. This time, oh.
Early in the seventh round as Hopkins barrels in again and digs to the body.
Well, I'll tell you what, blood just squirted all over my paperwork here, all over me.
Let him go.
There is no let up in this attack by Bernard Hopkins.
He says let him go, but Mercado ain't letting go. And I don't blame him. All it, that's it. That is it.
Brody Battle waving it off as he stands into the eyes of Mercado, who goes, what happened? What happened? And you see the exultation from Hopkins.
That is a funny reaction. He's standing up and the guy that won lay down in the right. The guy that won is laying down in the right.
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, he's laying down out of joy. He's standing up in disbelief, but he's getting his head handed to him round after round. I thought the stoppage might have been a little early, but I wasn't looking in the fighter's eyes. Rudy Battle's an excellent referee. Yeah,
and he wouldn't let go of him. He indicated he wouldn't let go. He didn't follow the orders. He had taken a substantial beating in that other corner. Substantial beating.
I believe the fight was stopped a little bit too prematurely, but as you know, he was, the leg went long. He was getting hit with a barrage of right hand, and eventually it took a toll on him.
Mike acknowledging Bernard Hopkins, looking down at Mike Tyson. 110, round 7, unofficially. A referee stops the contest, a TKO for Bernard Hopkins. Becomes the first middleweight champion from Philadelphia.
And Segundo Mercado has got to go back once again to a country that's disappointed in a futile attempt to bring a title back to Ecuador. He just didn't make it. It's odd that he came out with pants that has one written on him when his name is two.
Yes.
His name is Segundo, number two. Of course, he did prove to be number two today.
A country that really felt that Mercado won the first fight, even though it was ruled a draw. But no question about this one. It was very one-sided for Bernard Hopkins.
I get you.
Here's you watch the end of the fight. Bernard Hopkins still on the attack, landing those big right hands. He'd already hurt him with a couple, dug a few more on the inside. And part of the problem here was Segundo Mercado, Steve, would not let go. Rudy Battle asked him three times to let go, and he held on to the arm. So, you know, they eventually stopped it. And probably a good stoppage, but maybe just a little bit too early for the crowd's liking.
So Bernard Hopkins captures his first world title in his third try. Look at Rudy Battle trying to separate the two.
You know, if you look at that again, Steve, Hopkins had the other glove.
Uh-huh.
Hopkins had the glove under his arm.
Interesting. So now Bernard Hopkins, joyous as he sprawls out on the campus with a chance to really make a name for himself, not to mention some big money fights in the wide open middleweight division. Bernard Hopkins, now 27-2-1.
You watch inside here, they start to clinch. Watch the clinch here. And they turn. Hopkins, see the glove in the back? Hopkins has the glove clipped. His right hand is down holding Segundo's hand. See it?
Yes.
He's holding the glove. Mercado's not holding on. He can't get his hand out. Hopkins is holding the glove down. And therefore, the referee got the impression that Segundo Mercado wouldn't let go and was probably too hurt to continue. Could be a little deceiving there.
Yeah.
I could be wrong, but it didn't appear that way with the video.
Good replay, very revealing. Although he was really getting beat. He was getting destroyed. It's amazing that he was still standing.
Steve, I don't know why he didn't go down at least once.
Really? Well, we are standing by for the official announcement as Bernard Hopkins continues to celebrate. The crowd here at US Air Arena in Landover, Maryland, enjoying it. As Hopkins breaks the play.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a time of 1 minute 10 seconds in round number 7. The referee in charge, Rudy Battle, stops the contest. The winner by way of technical knockout and the new IBF middleweight champion of the world, the executioner, Bernard Hopkins.
So there you have it, Bernard Hopkins, the new IBF middleweight champion, as he wins the vacant title here in Landover.
You have been watching Tyson tapes all week. That's right. Told me. What'd you learn?
First, I'd like to say I'll give you all praises to the Lord as God, and I'd like to say thanks to my mother, Shirley Hopkins, right there, that everybody knows, that where everybody don't know, that's the real trainer. She beat my butt a couple of times. But, I'd like to thank Bowie Fisher, my main trainer, Don King, the world greatest promoter, co-partner, Butch Lewis, and Fareed Akhmed and all my group. Everybody home in Germantown, Philadelphia, I did it.
Let me ask you a question.
But Tyson, I've been watching his tapes. You got to have the killer instincts in this game, especially with these Reyes and Dom that you fight in. And, you know, just praying, keep praying God. And
the right, let's talk about the right hand. That seemed to be the thing that solved the problem. You were just dead on.
No, what I was, Doc, I was a little over anxious. I was glad to fight home. I was tight, and I wanted to get him out early. And I have to work on that, but... You know, as I got warmed up, I start working on the right hand. I've been watching tapes. I'm a tape freak. Everybody calls me for tapes. Bernard, give me the tapes. Give me the tapes. And, you know, I know we're going to get them back, but I've been watching Tyson, how he came for the first 20 fights as a professional. He ran through these guys. He didn't give them a chance to let them know what they have. And that's what I'm going back to. I'm going back to what I didn't do with Roy Jones.
Well, this time.
Giving no respect, Freddie. No respect.
He didn't get you in trouble, but he sure hit you low a lot of times.
Right.
How did you take that?
Well, I hit him back low.
That you did.
I hit him back low. That's all.
And the referee did a fine job.
You know what, Doc? I don't cry. This is a fight game. Nothing's fair in this game. I ain't no crybaby.
That's the way Butch Lewis always used to talk when he was fighting.
Wait a minute.
That's the way it is when you negotiate with Butch Lewis. It's all out in the table.
We're going to fight the next fight.
All right,
Butch. We always have our little fight.
Butch, tell me where we're going.
Well, right now I'm just thankful that we finally got a chance to fight here in our country, win the title. Bernard did a fine job. It was execution day today. I must say that Mercado put up a heck of a fight.
Yes,
he and he shouldn't be ashamed, and I'm sure we'll may have to contend with him again. We like to sit down and take a breather. I'm going to sit down and talk to DK, because he got a champion. He got out there calling Castro, who's a chump. We want him. I'm telling right now, here on Showtime.
Butch, you're back. Butch.
Your champion Butch. Away from us, because we want him.
Hey, Butch.
We want him.
Butch,
we want to knock all your fighters out
for
you.
You're back. Butch, you're back. You're back. I thought he was dead. He's back. Mr. Battle, you did a fine job in stopping that. Did you have any thoughts on why did you stop it?
Well, Freddie, he wasn't responding. I was speaking with him. I was talking with him, and he wasn't responding. And the only thing left for Mercado would have been that he would have been seriously hurt. If I had stepped back, there's no doubt about it that Bernard would have stepped in and executed a right hand, and he would have fallen to the canvas.
This is one you're not going to get any argument from anybody about.
Excuse me, I don't have that much time. But you got to meet the execution that raised and breeded the execution.
Well, you did a fine job of raising this.
Thank my mother for having me.
Thank you.
She's the real executioner, the pots and pans. She's the only one I know can throw a shoe, and I'm hiding behind another end and catch
me. Wait a minute, let me ask you a question. You think you can out negotiate this guy? All right. One, before we're looking around to see what happened with Mercado, but he's not here for an interview. So just one quick word about this fight as far as you saw it done.
This was a superb fight, another great night for Showtime. Bernard, the executioner, did a tremendous job. He was very sharp. He's a little anxious, but he was hitting him with right hands, one after another. Segundo Mercado had an iron jaw because he really stood up and took a lot of punishment tonight, and I thought the referee did a good job in stopping it.
Here comes Mercado.
Yes.
Bueno, Mercado. Peleaste muy bien, pero muy fuerte las derechazos. You fought well, but those right hands were too much.
No, hizo buenas derechas. Pero mal parada la pelea.
Said very good right hands, but he thinks it shouldn't be stopped.
En ningún mal me puso mal.
He said I was bad.
Yo estaba contragolpeándolo. Él estaba haciendo lo de él y yo lo mío, pero muy mala la pelea. Ayer el arbitraje estaba muy bien.
He said he felt that the referee was premature because he was punching back in counter punches, but apparently he didn't realize he didn't make any kind of response to the referee and he wouldn't let go. El problema era que tú no soltaste al otro boxeador y no le respondiste.
No, yo estaba contra yo él me siguió golpeando, yo seguía golpeándolo también.
And that's why they stopped the fight. He still thinks he was fighting it.
Era bien para la pelea, pero yo estaba respondiendo al castigo.
You understand what was happening? Are you in disagreement with this?
Yeah, of course. I mean, it was for the middleweight championship of the world, and if we're going to lose, we're going to lose on our face. But, you know, Secundo was fighting back.
But it's best that's time to fight another day. You yeah. Outside the ring. He's the one in here taking that punishment. It's better for him to fight another day.
All right. Well, look, the managers disagree. The fighters agree. They're both...
Yes. Me siento contento porque el título va a estar en buenas manos.
He said he's very happy because the title went in good hands to you.
Okay.
And so two fighters in the spirit of boxing agreeing with everything, as always happens when we have Don King and Butch Lewis together, they always agree on nothing. And so back to ringside and Steve out.